Delhi has literally become a PUBG battleground. In just 3 days, 3 shootings have rocked the protest sites at Shaheen Bagh and Jamia Nagar. On Friday, a 17-year-old youth brandished a gun at peaceful protesters near Jamia, shouting, "Here, take your freedom." He even shot at a student who confronted him, injuring him. But what was shock was that the entire scene unfolded in front of a heavy police force who stood as mere spectators. Moments before the incident, the accused had gone live on Facebook and claimed to be a supporter of Hindutva outfit Bajrang Dal. Another right-wing extremist group, Hindu Mahasabha, is even planning to felicitate the shooter and bear his legal expenses. However, he was let off after a day as he was said to be a juvenile. It has emerged that the youth got the gun and the bullets for just 10,000 rupees. Ironically, the Jamia incident happened on the 72nd anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi's assassination by Nathuram Godse, who was linked to extremist Hindutva groups then. Before the shock over the first incident could subside, another shooting incident gripped the capital city. This time, it was near Shaheen Bagh, where thousands of women and children have been protesting the CAA for nearly 2 months. Here, 25-year-old Kapil Gujjar fired 2 rounds in the air before being overpowered by the police. He also allegedly chanted Jai Shri Ram. The firings near protest sites is seen as a result of provocative remarks by BJP leaders during Delhi poll campaigning. While Minister of State for Finance Anurag Thakur had exhorted a crowd to chant "Shoot the country's traitors," BJP MP Parvesh Verma had said the Shaheen Bagh protesters might enter homes of Delhiites and rape them. But it did not stop there. A third shooting happened right in front of Jamia University gate. Students heard a gunshot around 11:30 p.m. and found 2 miscreants fleeing the spot on a red scooter. Amid a high-profile election campaign in Delhi, the shooting incidents raise several questions. First, aren't the Delhi police supposed to prevent such incidents from happening, especially as poll campaigning is hitting a peak? What has happened to the intelligence network? Why are these shootings targeted at protesters? How come the shooters have a Hindutva background? Do they get the support and patronage of Hindutva groups? Maybe this is why police has dealt with them softly. Is this all part of a bigger plan?